Hi, I'm Franco Rotoli from the Solidworks training team. This is the third video in the Beginner's Guide to xDesign series where I am modeling a phone holder. Today, I'll be modeling the back plate, which holds the phone and will be the base for all the other components in the assembly. Let's jump into xDesign and start modeling. From the xDesign main screen, I'll click New Component. I'll name it Backplate and note the collaborative space to which it's saved. Clicking OK will bring me into the xDesign environment. This time, I'm going to start my first sketch on the ZX plane. I'll click the plane and the Create Sketch icon from the pop-up. Just like the arm component, this backplate will have a consistent thickness, so I'll sketch an open profile for a thin extrusion. I'll also mine the inference lines and note the sketch relations. I'll dimension the two lines and add a sketch fillet in the corner. From the Extrude dialog, I'll choose Thin. This part will have a thickness of 5 mm and a width of 100 mm. I'll select Midplane for Direction 1 to keep it centered, and click the green check to complete the extrusion. Next, I'll make some cutouts through the back of the faceplate. These will give clearance for the arms. I'll start a sketch on this face. I want to keep the cutouts symmetric, so I'll sketch a centerline. To do this, I simply select my line tool and click the construction geometry icon at the top of my screen. This button stays active, so any sketch entities I create will have the centerline characteristics. I'll start at the origin and sketch it straight up and get the center point of this top edge. Notice the red square helping me to snap to it. I'll deselect the construction geometry icon so I can sketch solid rectangles for the cutouts. When I get close to the edge, a red circle comes up and my cursor snaps to the edge. This will add a coincident relationship. I'll finish the rectangle and add some dimensions. Now, since I have a centerline, I can mirror the rectangle about the centerline to maintain symmetry. To select the rectangle and centerline, I'll simply drag a selection box from right to left over both entities. xDesign sees that there's a centerline selected and gives me the option to mirror entities right from the pop-up menu. Next, I'll choose Center Rectangle from the Sketch toolbar. This is so I can start it from the origin, and it'll stay centered on my model. I'll dimension it, and the cutout sketch is complete. I'll click Extrude Cut from the Features toolbar. Since the sketch face I chose is in the middle of the model, I'll choose a mid-plane cut with a value larger than it needs to be in both directions. I also could have made it through all both. That would have allowed the cut to go through no matter what the size of the rest of the geometry. Next, I'll add some fillets to the front corners. I'll select this edge and choose Fillet from the pop-up. Notice the Design Assistant. I'll click it and it suggests 9 additional corners. This is more than I want. By clicking the settings icon, I can tell the Design Assistant what criteria to use in helping me select additional edges. I'll choose the option to have suggestions be in the same orientation as my original selection. Now these are the suggestions that I want. Notice if the fillet radius I choose is too big or will otherwise not work, xDesign shows me which ones will not work. In this case, I'll just change the radius to 12 millimeters. As a comparison to using the Design Assistant, I'll add some fillets to the cutouts by manually selecting the edges. You can see how much time the Design Assistant saves, even sped up 2 times. Finally, I'll add the last 4 fillets using the Design Assistant again. This time, clearing the requirement for having the same adjacent angles. In this case, it allows inside and outside corners. The next feature I want to create is a round bulb on the back that will interface with a swivel holder. I'll show the planes from the view menu so I can sketch on the ZX plane, which is centered on my model. This feature is going to be a revolve, so I only need to sketch half of the section profile. I'll start out with a line coincident to the back face. A neat shortcut to go from a line to an arc is to move your mouse back over the endpoint and then away. Notice my cursor changed from the line tool to the tangent arc tool. When I move my mouse away from here, xDesign will have changed the line to a tangent arc. I'll do that one more time to sketch the bulb section. Then close the sketch with two more straight lines. I'll add some dimensions to fully define the sketch. We see here that even though I added enough dimensions, the arc is still blue, which means it's underdefined, and I can still move it around. As I drag it around, we can see its center point is not defined. I can add sketch relations manually by holding Ctrl on my keyboard and selecting the two entities. In the pop-up, I'll choose coincident as the sketch relation. xDesign snaps the center point coincident to the line, and now my sketch is fully defined. Now, to revolve this sketch and make a solid. The Revolve tool is located next to the Extrude tool on the Features toolbar. This tool requires two pieces of input. We can see that Sketch 3 is already selected for the profile. This is because I was actively in the sketch when I clicked the tool. The second input is a Revolve axis. This can be a sketch line, a center line, an axis, or edge, which I want to use as the axis of revolution. Just make sure that the entire sketch is on one side of the axis to avoid geometrical issues. I'll choose this line, and we instantly get a preview. It looks good, so I'll accept it with the green check. Now I need a hole to accept a pin that holds the rest of the assembly together. I'll sketch a center line and position the hole on it to keep it centered on my model. I'll dimension it and create another through one-way cut. The last features I'll create are some guides for the arms. I have created a positioning sketch that I will show by selecting it in the Design Manager and selecting the Show icon. I could edit this sketch and add the geometry, or I can start a new sketch and just reference it. I'll do the latter. I'll start a new sketch on the back face and select the Slot Sketch tool. I'll add center point slots at the locations shown here. Since they'll all be the same size, I'll add an equal relationship to all the arcs. Remember, you can multi-select entities by holding down Ctrl on your keyboard while selecting them. Now, dimensioning one arc will change them all. I'll create a solid extrude of this sketch of 5 millimeters. Finally, I'll hide sketch 5 to clean up a little. In fact, if I slowly double-click on almost anything in the Design Manager, I can rename it. So I'll rename sketch 5 to something that will mean something to me the next time I open this file, like guide position. I like to save my files with an isometric view, so I'll change that from the view flyout and save my model. Thanks for watching. In the next video of this series, I'll be taking the components we've modeled so far and putting them together in an assembly. Stay tuned. And for even more great content, click the link in the description below to access additional tips, tricks, and training courses. And as always, happy modeling.